If I have to fold one more box, I'm gonna snap.
Did you say snap? Snap into a Slim Jim! Need a little excitement? Snap into a Slim Jim!
Son of a gun protectant. Nothing works better on your car's leather, vinyl, and rubber. It can turn just about anything into a great-looking car.
Nice car.
What, this pile of junk?
Give it the gun with Son of a Gun. And now give your tires a quick kick with one-step tire care.
Shake it, no dandruff. You've got Selsun Power. Brush it, no flakes. You've got Selsun Power with Selsun Blue. Doctors recommend it number one over all leading brands. Dandruff problem? No way. You've got Selsun Power.
It's just too early to make decisions. But I have to decide on breakfast, so I go to Burger King and get a flaky croissant sandwich, hash browns, and coffee for just $1.99. But then, do I get it to stay or to go?
Breakfast at Burger King.
1 week ago, there was a deadlock in the voting on the reinstatement of Nature Boy Ric Flair. Let's take you back to last week and show you exactly what happened.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you know, there has been a request by WCW heavyweight champion Hulk Hogan and Randy Macho Man Savage that Ric Flair be reinstated into the game. At this point, he is retired, and this will take a vote by this, the Executive Board of World Championship Wrestling, and we're going to take that vote right now, and I want to immediately go to Mr. Gary Jester for both your vote and any comment that you might have.
I'm a great admirer of Ric Flair and his career. However, he made an agreement with WCW in October that he would retire if he lost to Hulk Hogan, and I believe he should honor that commitment, and therefore I would vote no on the reinstatement.
Okay. One no. Now, Tatiana, the Paz of Spain, please, any statement and your vote.
Again, I say no. Mr. Flair is retired, and I will not vote against that. My vote is no.
That is a no?
Es un no.
Very good, that's two. Dieter Krupp of Germany, please, sir.
After what has happened during the last weeks, we ask our fans over the hotline, and they decided that Ric Flair should go back to the ring and have a competition against the Monster Maniacs during Hulkamania in Germany.
I will take that. That is a yes. Thank you very much. Mr. Ishikawa of Japan, please.
In reference to Ric Flair, I have spoken with our office in Japan. The return of Ric Flair is a good idea. Yes, of course.
I will take that as a yes. Very good. Thank you, Mr. Ishikawa. Christine LeBlanc, France.
Mr. Bockwinkle, I've decided to abstain from my decision at this time.
That is an abstention. You've just heard it, ladies and gentlemen. That is too far. Two against and one abstention, meaning that no action can be taken on the request and things will stay status quo. Ric Flair, at this point, is not re-entering the ring.
Well, that was last week, but right now, standing by in his office is Commissioner Nick Bockwinkle with a statement on what happened last week. Let's go to the commissioner this time.
Wrestling fans, I can understand your dismay over the deadlock in the voting by the WCW board on the reinstatement of Ric Flair. Wrestling fans, promoters, and the media from throughout the entire world, their response has just been astounding. People want to know, will Ric Flair be back in the ring or not? I can promise you that next week, the answer to this question will be finalized because the board will be meeting, world champion Hulk Hogan, Randy Savage will be there to present their case. I am saying it right now. The meeting will last until a decision has been finalized as to whether or not Ric Flair will be getting back into the ring or not. And you will see that historic decision right here on this program next week.
All right, there you hear the comments from Commissioner Nick Bockwinkle and Brain. Very simply, we are going to have another meeting next week with the WCW Board of Directors. And Bockwinkle promises a vote, a final vote, yes or no, and Hogan and Savage will be at that meeting.
And they're going to be sequestered. No one's leaving the room until there's a yes or a no.
That's right.
Well, I guarantee you, they spend any time in there with Bockwinkle, they'll talk in a minute. That door won't even have, you don't even have to lock that door.
Look at Meng a new look for him this week here on Saturday night. He is one dangerous individual.
Boy, is he ever.
Fans, I want to remind you that I will be talking later on in this telecast to the Macho Man Randy Savage and Hulk Hogan. They are here this week in the arena with us live, and they'll get their reaction to the comments from Nick Bockwinkel that you just saw and about their appearance next week in front of the board of directors.
Why don't you just ask them who's in their hip pocket, who they're paying off, who's on the take upstairs? That's what you should do. Have an investigation.
Just because you're used to underhanded deals doesn't mean everyone is.
I've never greased anybody's palm or slid anybody or bought anybody a gift or did anything like that. I've gotten where I'm at the hard way. I've earned it.
The hard way. Okay.
Meng. Few curves in the road, but they all have them.
Look, Joey Maggs is ready. He's Meng blocks it.
And good night, Mr. Maggs.
And nailed Joey Maggs right behind the ear. One, two, three. Maggs is out. It hasn't taken Meng long to destroy his opponents. And you just have to wonder, Brain, how long it will take before Colonel Parker unleashes this man after a major title. Maybe he'll be in the upcoming U.S. title tournament, and we'll talk more about later on in this telecast.
What everybody should be concerned with is after this man is unleashed, will Colonel Parker be able to stop him? That's what should be in everybody's mind. Look at Joey Maggs. Tries a cheap shot there. Meng's too smart for that. Heel of the foot right to the temple. Jumping Joey didn't jump too high there. The flopping fool instead of jumping Joey. It's over. Let's see who Tony Schiavone. Let's see what he's got to say with Colonel Parker. Get the stretcher.
Back with Colonel Parker, and there seems to be no defense for the awesome Meng in WCW.
That's true. You just hold that microphone up here good and high. I got something I want to say. You know, I'm going to tell you first about my feelings about Meng, and then I'm going to tell you about the world's feelings about Meng. First of all, you know, my heritage means so much to me, and everybody knows out there that Colonel Tom Parker himself is my great uncle. The heritage meaning so much, I must say, it comes secondary to the way that I promote Meng here. I want you to take a look at this diamond ring here on my pinky finger right here. You know, that diamond ring right there has special significance to me because Elvis Presley himself took it off of his middle finger. He's a smaller fella than me, you know, and inserted it on my pinky finger here, and I don't mind telling you how much it means to me. But it comes secondary to my promotion of Meng here. Now the world out there is asking themselves, what's wrong with Meng? I'll tell you, he got him shaking like a leaf up on a fuzzy tree. I'm talking about everything from Macho Man Randy Savage to the great Sting himself and right on to your world's heavyweight champion, Hulk Hogan. Each one of you, look in the face of this man right here, and I know you're shaking in your shoes. I'm going to guarantee you something. You go out now, find yourself a retirement haven of your choice, and go to it just as soon as you can get there. Because if you don't, I'm going to find one for you, and it's going to be the nearest hospital. Me here will be WCW's next world heavyweight champion, and I promise you that. Do you understand me?
Absolutely. Good day to you, and we'll be back with more on Saturday night.
Your time's just about up, Sting. 4 months ago, I was number one in WCW. Today, that's still true. Don't take my word for it, though. I'll prove it to you.